Good morning. Let's take a moment to turn to the people around us as we acknowledge each other's presence. And as we do so, let's also take this opportunity to lift each other in prayer before our loving Father. And as we pray for one another, let's also remember to pray for the peace that we long for, the end of violence of all kind against humanity, especially the unborn. Remember to pray for the poor, families that struggle, and victims of calamities. Today is the memorial of Saint Francis of Assisi. Let's now sing our entrance song, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where dost thou true faith in you? Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life. In the name of the Father, and Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. And as we gather to celebrate the sacred mysteries, like Saint Francis, we imitate his humility in recognizing his need for God's mercy and grace as we pray.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
You came to call sinners. Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, by whose gift Saint Francis was conformed to Christ in poverty and humility, grant that by walking in Saint Francis' footsteps, we may follow your Son, and through joyful charity, come to be united with you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Nehemiah. In the month of Nisan of the 20th year of King Artaxerxes, when the wine was in my charge, I took some and offered it to the king. As I had never before seen sad in his presence, the king asked me, "Why do you look so sad? If you are not sick, you must be sad at heart." Though I was seized with great fear, I answered the king, "May the king live forever. How can I look sad when the city where my ancestors are buried lies in ruins, and its gates have been eaten out by fire?" The king asked me, "What is it then that you wish?" I prayed to God of the heavens and answered the king, "If it please the king, and if your servant is deserving of your favor, send me to Judah, to the city of my ancestors' graves, to rebuild it." Then the king and the queen seated beside him asked me how long my journey would take and when I would return. I set a date that was acceptable to him, and the king agreed that I might go. I asked the king further, "If it please the king, let the letters be given to me for the governors of west of the Euphrates, that they may afford me safe conduct until I arrive in Judah. Also a letter for Asaph, the keeper of the royal park, that he may give me wood for timbering the gates of the temple, citadel, and for the city wall, and the house that I shall occupy." The king granted my request, for the favoring hand of my God was upon me. The word of the Lord. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. By the streams of Babylon we sat and wept when we remembered Zion. On the aspens of the land we hung up our harps. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. Though there are captors against us, asked of us the lyrics of our songs, and our despoilers urge us to be joyous, sing for us the songs of Zion. Let my tongue be silenced. How could we sing a song of the Lord in a foreign land? If I forget you, Jerusalem, may my right hand be forgotten. Let my tongue be silenced. May my tongue cleave to my palate if I remember you not, if I place not Jerusalem ahead of my joy. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I consider all things so much rubbish that I may gain Christ and be found in him. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus and his disciples were proceeding on their journey, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." Jesus answered him, "Foxes have dens and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to rest his head." And to another he said, "Follow me." But he replied, "Lord, let me go first and bury my father." But he answered him, "Let the dead bury their dead, but you go and proclaim the kingdom of God." And another said, "I will follow you, Lord, but first I must But first, let me say farewell to my family at home. Jesus answered him, "No one who sets hand to the plow and looks to what was left behind is fit for the kingdom of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Today we have the memorial of Saint Francis of Assisi, whose life story and who we are very familiar with, especially how he lived a life of poverty and humility, as our opening prayer said. But this is not until after he first in his young days led a depraved life. What is a depraved life? You can Google it, and you can Google his life. But at the end, when he realized that nothing of that life can give him that happiness, he had a yearning for something more, for something that he can do. It was one of the stories that he was in, if I'm not mistaken, Porciuncola, when he had a rundown church. When he saw an icon cross, very same like this icon cross that we have, and he heard in his mind and in his heart, "Build my church." So he thought it was that church, that small chapel. So he started building it, and people were laughing at him and say, "Look at what this crazy person is doing." It was then he heard that voice and started building the church, that he renounced everything, because his family was very wealthy at that time. And it was when that he made that fundamental option, like we heard in the gospel, that Jesus is challenging us, that he left everything behind and follow our Lord. And unlike any ordinary contract or covenant or commitment we make here on earth, it doesn't have the fine print. You know, how always when we enter into contract or into an agreement, people will always say, "Read the fine print." But with our Lord Jesus, when we make that fundamental option, there's no fine print, because he was very clear. He said, "If you wish to follow me, deny yourself, take up your cross, and come follow me." He did not say that we will not fail or we will not make mistakes, because we will, each one of us. And we cannot even compare ourselves to others, because each one of us makes that fundamental or essential choice of following our Lord Jesus in our own uniqueness. And that's how we live it as well. And that's also the mercy and compassion of God that allows us to practice that humility of recognizing ourselves and following our Lord Jesus, and with the guidance of His Spirit, discovering our own unique way of how God can be with us, and God can be with us, as Deacon Dan said yesterday, and we can manifest Him to others. There's one brother who became part of St. Francis' group of disciples or followers, and he was so excited when St. Francis said to him, "Come, let's preach at this town." So he's so excited because St. Francis was popular already, and said, "Wow, I will be with him." So they walked through town bringing their begging bowl, if you might want to call it that. But they began to beg for their community and those that they're caring for. And they left town afterwards. And the disciple said, Brother Francis, I thought we were going to preach." And Brother Francis smiled and said, "Yes, we did preach. We preach with our lives. And if necessary, we will use words." And I think that's the challenge to us. Not as we say so much, but we do much as we can, and as much as the Spirit and the grace of God can allow us to do. Our entrance song reminds us of who St. Francis stood for peace in our hearts, peace with one another, and peace with the whole of God's creation. Let's pray that he may make us, through his intercession, God may make us channels and instruments of his peace and love, because God is with us because we invite him to be with us. Saint Francis of Assisi, pray for us. Assisi abandoned everything and lived a life of poverty and charity. Following his footsteps, may we mirror the face of Christ to others.
Our response, Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
Like Saint Francis, may we follow the example of the Lord, who, though he was rich, became poor, so that through his poverty, we might become rich. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
May Saint Francis, who loved and even preached to birds, animals, and flowers, teach us to commune with all creation and to praise and thank God for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
Endowed with Saint Francis's spirit, may all join in caring for Mother Earth, our common home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
May the Lord make us channels of his peace to overcome hatred with love, doubt with faith, and to pardon those who have injured us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
May we, delivered from the fear of death, whom Saint Francis called Sister Death, for it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit. We lift up to the Lord the intentions and petitions we have in the silence of our hearts for our families and our loved ones in the Ark of Prayer chest. We lift up to him the intentions for whom this Mass is offered, for the intentions of Rosita Kimlat, Adrian M., and Brian Castro, and for the eternal repose of the soul of Pio Jose Martinez, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
And for the intentions submitted to us in thanksgiving for Teresa Ortega, John Palanca, Jade Garcia, Aguilar family, and Ludette David, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
For those in need of comfort, strength, and healing, Lorenzo Moran, Victoria Pineda, Nancy Scott, Kimberly Pham Hewitt, Judy Morgan, Barbara Yanchar, Lumi Palacio, Hussein Makaluwas, John Donahue, Diane Weber, John Wilson, Thomas Couchard, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
And for our dearly departed, Bernd Schluter, Manuel L. Sanchez, Maria del Rosario Castro, Mil Tennant, Nadine Bendigo, Angel Sarosa, and Oscar Vergara, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, teach us to be poor in spirit.
Lord God, you care for the birds of the air and the lilies of the field. May Saint Francis, patron of ecology, help us to treat every living thing with kindness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for to your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, to become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for to your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, to become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we bring you these offerings, O Lord, we pray that we may be rightly disposed for the celebration of the mystery of the cross, which Saint Francis so ardently embraced. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of Saint Francis, you bid your church rejoice. So too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, pleni sunt caeli et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini. Hosanna in excelsis. You're indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, Timothy, Thomas, and Todd, his brother bishops, all the bishops, priests, deacons, religious, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Santiago de Compostela, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace with you. Peace with you. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Communion antiphon. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. For those unable to receive our Lord Jesus sacramentally, in the silence of our hearts, we can pray the act of spiritual communion. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, through these holy gifts which we have received, that imitating the charity and apostolic zeal of Saint Francis, we may experience the effects of your love and spread them everywhere for the salvation of all through Christ our Lord. We now pray to our loving Mother. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. To Saint Joseph, hail guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To you, God entrusted his only Son. In you, Mary, place her trust. With you, Christ, was secure and safe. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father and guide us to the paths of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. And may God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless all of you and your loved ones, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Our recessional song is Loving and Forgiving. Loving and forgiving are you, O Lord. Slow to anger, rich in kindness, loving and forgiving are you. All my being, bless the Lord, bless the holy name of God. All my being, bless the Lord, remembering the goodness of God. Loving and forgiving are you, O Lord. Slow to anger, rich in kindness, loving and forgiving are you. Have a blessed day, everyone.